The shadow's gone because I'm using a fill light, but there's a new shadow because I'm using a fill light. Hey there, Kazen here, and welcome back to Always Doing. Today I'm coming at you with the Would You Read It challenge. This is a fun one, originally by Bear over at A2 Brody. I was tagged by the wonderful Xander over at This Cubed, and the idea is that I will read the first line or lines of a book, and you can decide, number one, if you recognize it, number two, if it's something you'd like to read, and I want to add a bit more of a twist to it. So I have chosen books from four different categories: general fiction, poetry, nonfiction, and romance. So that's another way you could play, is to listen to the lines and decide which category you think it's from. I'm seeing my job as selling you on the book just from the first few lines, hopefully making you interested to click on the links down below to see the Goodreads page and the rest. And if you're the kind of person that likes reading along as someone else is reading, turn on the closed captions. I edit them myself. They will be as close to letter perfect as I can manage, and it'll all be down there. And I'm gonna keep the genres on the screen just as a reminder of your choices for category if you decide to go that route. Now, I've given all these books 4 or 5 stars, but I wanted to cast a wide net, so some of them I haven't talked about recently, like in the past year or two. Some of them I'm not sure I've talked about at all. If there is a review, I will link it in the cards and down below. And that's that, so let's head right into it. Perhaps you picked up this book because an icy hand grips your viscera, sometimes squeezing, sometimes easing, always present. And you suspect that this intimate violation, this forced entry, proceeds from something more profound than politics. You imagine that reality itself is engaged in an epic existential battle, and you stand helpless against the onslaught as the truth is crumpled into dust. The Trouble with Reality, A Rumination on Moral Panic in Our Time by Brooke Gladstone. This came out in 2017, so right at the beginning of the Trump presidency, and it's nonfiction. I've never seen the point of fancy dress parties. You have two choices. Either you make a massive effort and wind up looking like a dick, or you make no effort and wind up looking like a dick. And my problem, as always, was not knowing what kind of dick I wanted to be. Boyfriend Material by Alexis Hall, Romance. On the island where I come from, women rule. They run the country, control the wealth, and decide who will do what, why, and when. At the end of the day, when the sun sinks into the sea, the women leave their offices behind and go out on the town to enjoy what is known as the women's hour. In bars, restaurants, and spas designed for women only, they relax and let out a sigh as the day's thoughts and fears rush off their skin like water. There they linger as day fades from the sky, chatting among themselves, making occasional cracks about the guys. Men, they say, are such incomplete souls. They don't even know how to love, they say, as they grow calm in the light of their minds before returning to their homes, their men, their children, their dogs. Why God is a Woman by Nin Andrews. This is poetry. It's kind of cheating. It's prose poetry, but it's still poetry. There exists this city built by labor, mostly men who disappear after their respective buildings are made. Once the last brick is laid, the glass spotless, the elevators functional, the plumbing operational, the laborers, every single one of them, begin to fade before disappearing completely. Temporary People by Deepak, Unnikrishnan. This is general fiction, short stories. Henry Lofumf Holland, the first Earl of Slane, had existed for so long that the public had begun to regard him as immortal. The public as a whole finds reassurance in longevity, and after the necessary interlude of reaction, is disposed to recognize extreme old age as a sign of excellence. The long liver has triumphed over at least one of man's initial handicaps, the brevity of life. All Passion Spent by Vita Sackville West, general fiction. Carolyn is a tall, gorgeous, charismatic trans woman who has driven in a big rig in Texas and the rest of the South for the past 8 years. The day I spoke to her, she had pulled into a truck stop for the night in South Carolina. It was 2016, maybe a month after North Carolina had passed House Bill 2, widely known as the bathroom bill because it required people to use the bathroom that agreed with the gender on their birth certificate. Carolyn told me how she planned to respond the following day after crossing into that state. If I get anywhere near the capital of North Carolina and I need to use the restroom, I'm going to use the steps of the courthouse, or the Capitol building. That's just because I know I can't get anywhere near the governor's mansion, or I'd go take a whiz on their azaleas. Semi-queer, Inside the Lives of Gay, Trans, and Black Truck Drivers by Anne Balay, nonfiction. Mish Sullivan hated hospitals. The harsh light, the antiseptic smell, the curtains and lack of privacy, and all the bad memories being in one dredged up. All those times back when she'd been a teen, sitting at her mom's side, waiting for the inevitable to happen. Reverb by Anna Zabo, third book in the Twisted Wishes series, romance. Somewhere a sun. Below, boys brown as rye play the dozens and ball, jump in the air and stay there. Boys become new moons, gum dark on all sides, beg bruised blue water to fly, at least hide, at least spit back a father or two. I won't get started. Don't Call Us Dead by Danez Smith, poetry. Walking through a field with my little brother Seth, I pointed to a place where kids had made angels in the snow. For some reason, I told him that a troop of angels had been shot and dissolved when they hit the ground. He asked who had shot them, and I said a farmer. Actual Air by David Berman, poetry. The survivor's tale is the essential document of our time. All of us have them. Even babies have them. To be born now is no guarantee that you will not be touched by war day. Indeed, birth makes it certain. So we are all survivors, and those of us who actually lived through that day carry our histories with us, our stories of how we did it, of what particular luck or strength or cleverness saw us through. War Day by Whitley Strieber and James Konietka, fiction. They don't tell you what happens when you're not next of kin. There are so many ways for the authorities and the family to keep you in the dark when you and your partners don't put anything in writing. When you keep your declarations private, that privacy comes with consequences. It takes 3 days for me to find out that Corrine isn't just missing, she's dead. And then I have to tell Shaw. Harbor by Rebekah Weatherspoon, romance. So how did you do? Were you able to guess categories? Were you able to figure out a book or two? And did I pique your interest in any of these? Let me know down in the comments below. And oh, tag people. I'm gonna tag people. Let's go with some people that I haven't tagged recently. Greg at Supposedly Fun, Nicole at Nicole Is Here to Learn, and Leo at Leo Bancroft, brand new channel. I would love to see your take on this tag, as well as anybody else who decides to give it a try. Let me know down in the comments, leave your link. Thank you all so much for watching. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.